talk about the National Water Quality Assessment Program, and part of a component of that is our agricultural chemical transport study. This is a study looking at the effects of agriculture on water quality at 7 different sites across the country. And today, specifically, though, we're going to be talking about an area in northwest Mississippi. Our Mississippi alluvial plain is commonly referred to as the Delta. And we're going to talk to some farmers, we're going to talk to some scientists, and we're going to take a little bit of a tour of the Delta. So, Jeannie, tell us a little bit about what you've been doing for the agricultural chemical transport study.
So, I've been working on the role of groundwater surface water exchange on the transport of agricultural chemicals in the Bogue-Fly Basin.
And why is this important to study?
Well, actually, at first we thought it wasn't important to study. We've sampled the groundwater in the Delta extensively and have never found much of any agricultural chemicals in the groundwater. And so the assumption was that there was very little interaction between the surface water and the groundwater, since the surface water always had agricultural chemicals in it of some form. What we found is that actually it's not the hydrology that's preventing the exchange of groundwater surface water, it's the chemistry of our groundwater system. And so, for example, in our study area, found that we actually were in connection with the aquifer, and we were generally gaining and losing, so the movement of water both ways, but it was the chemistry within the stream bed and the aquifer that was actually causing nitrogen, this example, to be reduced to N2.
And what are the major conclusions that you found from this study?
We find that we have huge swings in both the direction of the movement of water between the groundwater and surface water, and also that this has fairly large impact on the chemistry of surface water, and could have impact on what we're finding in the ground.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.